Yeah.
I walked up to it.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Anti-Up Chicago Charity Classic, presented by the Windy City Poker Championship. We're at Southwest Community Services for this great charity event benefiting the Shady Oaks Camp. I'm Scott Long.
And I'm Jason Salmon. Now, the Shady Oaks Camp at Southwest Community Services helps adults and children with disabilities. I think that's a great charity to have here.
Very good cause, and we have plenty of people out here. We've got 50 or so players starting already. Still time to get in.
And it's a $1,000 buy-in, Scott. It's gotten deep.
Absolutely. Well above my pay grade.
Well, I'm going to jump in there.
I know it's below yours because you're supposed to be in this tournament right now.
Yeah, I'll lose a few chips here and there, but that'll be all right. I got to give you some company in here.
All right, cards are in the air. I've always never wanted to say that.
We got Larry first act here. And he's throwing them away.
Love this RFID technology.
Raise to 1,000. Pretty amazing.
Cards right away.
I brought this guy.
I don't think you're allowed to do that first hand, Ron.
Ron's going to raise to 1,000.
Big ace king. Well, he's starting out ahead. That's always important.
All right, a couple suited connectors make the call.
Here we go to the flop. That's an interesting flop there, Scott.
This is going to be a fun hand, I think.
Essentially,
flush draw, straight draw with top pair, top kicker.
It's going to be a good one. Maybe we'll have an out in the first hand.
We'll be home by dinner.
Sounds good.
Heads up. Now, surprisingly, all three of them are going to see the turn.
Six thousand.
Things looking better for Joel.
And he makes the call.
Big river now. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
What a river card.
Let's see what Ron does. We got check, check.
Oh, check, check.
Interesting. Playing a little timid at the beginning of this one.
Splashed around with 7-8 suited hits and then gets cautious on the river. All right. Nice pot, though.
Yep. To each his own.
21,000 and so.
I revised my earlier question. Who brought that guy?
And Joel jumps out with the early lead here with 51,300.
Just like that. 8 high.
Hope that happens to me for the whole tournament.
Well, it's not going to happen to you here in the first hour while you're in here with me.
Do I have to show them if I'm folding, or does it not matter?
Well, you should just fold anyway. Yeah. So
just take them on there a couple of seconds and then muck them?
Yeah. Okay. I can't put this way.
Oh, look at this. Joel gets back-to-back 7-8 suited connectors.
You know he was coming back in with that one.
Ever wonder how fun it would be in a tournament if you had the same hand every single time?
It could be interesting. Depends on the hand. We got some interesting cards to the flop on this one.
A little tougher for Joel to win this one, I think. Oh, but they're going to keep him in. Does a 9. I'm going to quit right now.
Nope, not this time.
$500. The bet.
15.
Raise to 1,500.
Should get a split pot coming up here, unless somebody can bet somebody out.
Got a call. Probably chopping. Yep, inside strengths.
Choppy, choppy.
Yep.
I made a huge lead on a head top pair.
So, Jason, this is your first time in Chicago.
This is my first time in Chicago. I got to try the famous deep dish pizza last night. It was pretty amazing.
The best part of the deep dish pizza, it's indoors.
Yeah, it's quite an experience with the weather here coming from Tampa, Florida.
Yes, for a couple Floridians, this is not primo weather for us.
We almost didn't make it in today. We definitely wouldn't make it in tomorrow with all the snow coming in. Luckily, the tournament is also indoors.
Oh my gosh, Joel, another connected hand. At least it's not suited this time.
We got some similar hands coming in on this one.
Raise to 600.
I think I'm going to want to see a 9 on this flop.
That would sound like a good one. Pretty much any middle straight cards.
Lots of people want to play in this tournament.
I think the structure is key on that.
Well, the flop came a little lower than we were hoping for action here.
We did have David flop the nuts right now. Redraws
check
in there.
Yep, letting raise the Joel down. Hang himself. Nope.
Raise it up. He said, no way.
That's an interesting check raise, isn't it? His hand's really well disguised.
Yeah.
We don't have to go any further.
I think he wants to win this one right now.
Yeah, Dave's going to win that. I think he put a little value on the table there.
Yep. Maybe a little too quick on the trigger there. And Joel is still our chip leader right now with 48.1 thousand.
Hands like that, that's a Masters of the Universe hand, right?
It is.
Sure? I love it. Skeletor?
Skeletor.
Yes, sir.
By the power of Grayskull.
Live TV, we have mistakes.
He's down there somewhere. Panthor is down there somewhere.
Finally get another view of the other side of the table.
Now I know how the other half lives.
We have absolutely no technical skills here. Kirk, our producer, has only slightly more than we do.
Calls 400.
We got Joel with pocket tens. I feel like Joel's in every one of these hands.
Two suited connectors in this hand.
Raise to 2400.
3, actually. Sorry.
Calls 24.
One's out now, though.
Calls 24.
Jason jumping in the pot.
Finn.
But a pins.
Uh-oh. We're the best of them.
He'll be cycling in here, joining me later on. Hopefully not because he's out of the tournament.
About to say.
25. 2,500.
Not a good flop for pocket tens.
For the winner.
Winner.
Not a good flop for any three hands, though. All it takes is a bet, right?
That's right. A bet and a win.
You too?
I had a very similar hand to the one I had the hand before.
Yeah.
Small suited connector.
Yeah. Hey guys, hope you don't mind. I thought I'd join you on the microphone. This is Kirk Fall, the executive producer of Windy City Poker Championship.
We all respect.
Figured I'd give you guys a little bit of information about what we're doing, why we're doing it, and what to expect throughout the day. Of course, we have a live broadcast of our TV table this time. And every player in the tournament is going to get an opportunity to play at the TV table. We're going to rotate it in and out. And I know, Jason, you're going to be at the feature table for the second hour.
I'll be in there.
Scott Long really wants to play, but we decided not to front him the $1,100 buy-in.
I've never played a tournament more than $65 in my life.
And we are eight-handed at the TV table, and these players were thankful enough to have made it at the first hour because they prepaid. We like to give incentives to players that take the initiative. So they prepaid their entry. They saved $100, so they got in for $1,000. And, of course, they got the first opportunity. So every hour we'll rotate, and then the next eight players that prepaid will get their opportunity to play
for an hour. And then hopefully we'll get everybody a chance, and then we will have a random draw from there on out until we have a winner at the end of the night.
Excellent.
I think that's important for everyone listening to remember, is for the next tournament, to make sure you buy in early so you get a chance to get on that TV table first.
Because, you know, poker players are known for buying in early to tournaments.
A hint of sarcasm.
Jack 10. I've lost more money with that hand than any hand in poker. See if Mike can play it better than I can.
Check. Interesting flop here. Interesting flop.
Check's good.
Looks like Joel's ace is still ahead here.
Check.
We're playing a little tight here at the beginning.
Yeah.
Sixes, queen, aces, aces, and sixes.
Sometimes people just don't want to get out of the tournament early.
Well, no one wants to go home on the TV table.
You're right about that, Scott.
Yeah, no.
There's so much shame in getting knocked out of a poker tournament in general.
Then to just put it on TV.
Actually, yes. People are watching you and watching you that
you found the
walk
one
of shame.
That I wasn't talking, and now
much
you
more difficult.
To
I got double slow rolled.
Everybody else was excited.
Looks like Jason Finn is talking to us. Can't hear him. Hi, Jason.
I feel jealous that there's two Jasons in this tournament. I thought really I was going to have the glory on this one.
I'm going to guess there's probably more than two.
Rats. This isn't what I was promised.
100 to play.
Some real winning hands right here.
Yeah. Could be a walk.
Played mine too.
Raise the 350. The gun.
Yeah. Yeah. Uh-oh.
Oh, here we go.
Bad time to make a move from the small blind.
Do you smooth call here, Scott?
I do, don't you?
I guess it depends on the player.
I know we've only seen a couple hands so far, but it doesn't seem like these players like to disguise their hands much.
Yeah, that's true.
It's a very in-your-face group we have here. Oh, you knew that was coming, right?
Right out the beginning. No way.
That was coming. And poor Ron is going to probably come alive here and feel bad about it.
22.
I think Paul could easily be check raising here.
Oh, he's gonna bet straight out. That's not good. Having.
There's not. You're right. There's not much disguising there.
Yeah. Although it's a tough board right now, so.
Oh, we got a call.
Gets the call though.
Down to the river.
The river card could really change this.
Oh,
and boy did it. And that's not even what I meant.
The queen. Wow.
I was thinking something like an 8 or a club would make it a little difficult.
Nope, just the 6% queen.
That was amazing. That was a pump fake.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh, boy.
There it is.
That was amazing.
Boys and girls, this is why you quit poker.
I would like to take my sack out of the tournament now.
You know, that's why they put 5 cards out on the board, right?
That's right. And Ron earning back a little of his chips there in that hand.
I'd have been afraid.
Got a Patriots fan in here at the feature table.
I'm a Patriots fan now.
I'm a Katy Perry fan now. After my Packers lost the way they did, I didn't want to watch.
I can't believe we're in the commentary. I can't believe we're in the commentary room together, Cowboys fan versus Patriots fan.
That I can afford. Three players.
Check. Yeah, after a couple of hands of like stack cards, now we're getting to what poker's really.
A lot of folding.
Hey Jim. Getting a real glare down here. These guys are having trouble seeing the cards. Is there any adjustment that could be?
I think it's just the glare.
Most exciting hand at the tournament. Tough to top that one.
You know what? Just crank it up a little bit.
Pretty sick beginning.
Wait, Zach doesn't seem to be having any trouble seeing the cards. So.
Blind this guy.
Yeah. I put the sunglasses on just like.
So you play these tournaments more than I do, Jason. The early rounds here when the blinds are so low and the chip stack so high, what's your goal here? Is it just to kind of feel the other players out? Or?
Yeah, essentially, you know, really I'm just trying to see what everyone's about at the table. I want to see kind of their strategies and the type of aggression that they're playing with, and then kind of make my long-term strategy from there. I also like to survive. That's always good, especially at the TV table.
Very good goal.
but that's definitely my strategy at the beginning, is to feel everything out. Depending on the table, I may get a little more playful, a little more aggressive, but in general, I'm feeling them out.
Sure.
What about you, Scott? What about in the early parts of a tournament?
Early parts of the tournament, I'm at home. I do the Phil Hellmuth. I show up about 3 hours late, play my short stack to victory.
That's always good. You can never get out in the first couple levels if you're not there. That's my strategy currently.
But no, seriously, I think you're right. You don't want to take big gambles early on here until you know the players. You know, the interesting thing about here is a lot of these players do know each other. We had a fair amount of players that have flown in for this event, which is very nice, but a lot of these players know each other already, so.
It's a pretty simple hand there.
Poor Jax.
I've heard more people whine about Jax probably than about any hand.
And you know, when you hear people whine about it, they're like, oh, I throw them away all the time, and no one ever throws away Jax.
Yeah, that's pretty much my thought all the time is, well, I'm not going to do that. I love when you have people talk about their favorite hands, and their very strange favorite hands. Like, I like 6-4, I like 7-8. I'm like, I like pocket aces. And people complain about them all they want, but I'll take them every hand.
Absolutely.
Ron going to make a raise here. Just a call.
Option?
800.
Raise to 800.
5 would make this hand interesting.
What, you sound differently?
Yeah, that's what they say.
You put on the voice over. Yeah.
Jason, comes your
back now.
I'm trying to sound like Ron, which...
All right.
Let's see if Jax can survive this one.
Well, I got a free ride here, man.
Want to sound like Ron?
If you could bother Ron Major's voice, you would...
Up. Ron's in it to win it.
That's the best voice on TV.
And you know the ace is going to come, right? If you're going to make a loose call
right
like
in the
that.
Window. Not this time.
2,000.
Really good flop for Jax there.
And he takes it down. Ron been involved in a lot of the action here at the beginning of this tournament.
That was a very loose call.
I don't think I've ever had a flop like that with Jax. I think every flop I've had with Jax has an ace, king, or queen, or all three.
It seems to always. At least those are the ones you remember.
And you always remember the bad ones.
Can we do a straddle on the...
Always.
No one remembers the quad, flopping the quad aces.
Both front and back.
Because that never happens.
Just remember the guy with the deuce tray of clubs that run you down.
I have a straddle right after the blind raise. No? You get blind raise?
In a Kirk event.
Blind raise. Yeah. You don't get action, no. Yeah. There's no action. Okay. No option.
Not yet to the point of tournament where people are playing 4-6 offsuit. It's a bummer for our at-home audience.
That's why they're at home.
Check.
Nice looking banner there, Joel.
500.
Yeah. Just for our eyes only.
Is it?
I hope this is exactly how the tournament is when I'm in it. Check, call, flop. That sounds nice. Sure. Everyone plays nice.
It's kind of like the morning calisthenics before you go for the run, right?
Exactly. You got to stretch out, you know. This is the yoga phase of the tournament.
That's true.
Actually, yoga's pretty extreme. I can't even say that.
Just keep it up there.
I sent them all to Joel.
But Scott, you're an avid yoga doer, correct?
Oh, of course. Absolutely. I have some of the best yoga pants in Clearwater, Florida.
Just always out on the beach, 5:30 a.m.
My son recorded a video for Joel.
Sheer tank top?
You said yoga. I thought you meant yogi.
Oh.
Yes, yep. Yeah. Big Yogi Bear fan.
He just knows the truth.
Vacation at Jellystone every year.
Old Jellystone.
Yeah, come on. If anybody's going to play 3-6, it's going to be Joel. But not going to oblige this time.
Raise the 300.
Paul raises it up.
You didn't want to get off the boat. I had to try to get the captain's hat back on.
Raise the 1,200.
Dogs are looking pretty good for him right now. Oh, until Jason got a little frisky there.
A little abnormal raise there. We haven't heard much from Jason. He's trying to make a play here.
$1,200 all day.
It could be successful, but not this time.
Let's see what the flop brings him.
Check.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Jason has to think he could be good here.
Yes.
And we might have a big hand.
1,300.
And I'm rooting for him having the same name and everything.
And you never like the less than 1% graphic on the screen when
it's
you're
not
holding
the most
cards,
fun one.
Right?
If only he could see what we see.
Raise the 3,800.
All right, what's Paul going to do here?
Raising it up.
Is there a way to move?
No.
Again, I think
it's
some value, right?
Yeah, I don't. I can't see
the reason.
No flush
possibility there. No straight possibility.
The only thing is, there is a chance here that Jason could re-raise, thinking that he's just trying, just someone's just trying to push him out of the pot. So maybe he's on another level than we were even thinking. Not this time.
See the remainder of the hand to you.
And Jason gets away from that one.
You made the call, you might have seen the end of the hand.
Yes, no, I seeded the hand.
Wow. Retreat.
That could have been a big one.
I'm going to say Paul probably cost himself about 5,000 units there.
Most definitely. I think that hand could have definitely went to the river.
Mind that flop. Yeah. Seems like it was
just dropped down.
I had two pair.
All I thought I had done was talk you into a check on the river. That was all I was hoping.
Gentlemen taking the photos, there is Don Bates, our first Ante Up World Championship world champion.
Board unless you had one of those.
That was the title I always wanted.
And of course, that's the shirt he wore on the cover of our magazine. Play reckless. That's my Jack 10 again.
Your favorite hand keeps
popping
up. I'm
going to guess that Zach is going to play it a lot better than I would.
Raise to 1650.
I don't think on this one. We'll see how it goes. But that's never fun when you open up the raise. Just the immediate aces behind you. It's going to be a tough call here, I think, pre-flop with 10-jack.
And then they just show them on that little monitor. Right?
Although early in the tournament, this is the kind of time you like to gamble with a hand like that.
True. I prefer it suited.
And that's why Zach's sitting there instead of me.
Yeah, that's not losing every hand.
Try play. No. Take it easy.
You have to be
just 15 or 100.
Joel, you're short of the
now, with a $1,000 buy-in in this tournament, the final prize is going to be pretty great.
How long are the rounds?
30 minutes total.
Probably one of the biggest tournaments ever to come to Tinley Park, Illinois.
Tinley Park. It could be the only tournament to ever come to Tinley Park, Illinois.
Cute town, though. I went for breakfast this morning here and drove around. And, you know, it's one of these places that you wouldn't come had there not been a poker tournament. So,
true. Funny story.
One of the great things about poker.
Actually, we went to breakfast this morning, which is the closest place to here, a little sports bar around the corner.
Oh, really?
I had pizza and wings at 9 a.m. this morning.
Oh, I wish I would have found that out.
Check.
First breakfast place I went to had a line out the door.
You went to the wrong
place. I
had
to yelp another one.
400.
And I know I could have got pizza and wings. I would have been all over that.
Missing out.
Breakfast of champions.
Now, if I'm asleep on the table, you know why.
One thing you could have made that breakfast better was beer.
That's the only way.
Kind of hard to have pizza and wings without beer, even at 9 a.m.
We got an interesting hand heating up here. Open-ended against flush draw. It would be great for both to come.
We're going to get our opportunity. One of them got there.
Check. Thousand and a quarter.
Yep. Pretty easy fold on that
no
one.
No chance on that call there.
Oh, well, we see that.
That's just going to give you extra information. I thought you were saying something different altogether.
Very cool.
Wow.
kind of poker gods make it really.
I bet a quarter on that I was getting out of the way.
Joel still in the lead here.
Raise to 300.
Now, would you push people around at this stage in the tournament with a bigger stack?
I don't think so. I think we talked about before. People are still trying to fill each other out. Although I guess it's a good time to, if you're not normally aggressive, to act aggressive because you got the chips to do it, and then
most definitely
be able to change gears later on.
Check.
And how important is that in tournament play to change gears?
It's everything, isn't it?
I think too many players get set in that mindset of, I'm going to play tight today or I'm going to play aggressive, and that's all they'll play, and they won't evolve or change based on the table change.
Yeah.
There you go. I think they'd be good for your image.
Yeah. I mean, the one thing that if you can solve, you'll win poker all the time, is making sure your opponents have no idea what you're doing.
It's always the most important. You're the ghost of the table.
And if they don't know what you're doing, and you can figure out what they're doing, lights out.
Even better.
Charlie Sheen in Major League.
I wore the Eddie Vedder one.
Nice.
Nice, I like it. Was it baseball game?
Paul jumping out of that hand with Queen Jack of Hearts preflop.
Yeah, that's a little
tight,
I thought.
Be careful.
Very tight, I thought.
Shows up there a lot.
Now, Scott, I've been on one of the great Antiup cruises, but when is the next Antiup cruise?
Actually, next week, February 9th.
That's not fair. You call it work all the time, but you're just always cruising.
Oh,
let's be honest.
Absolute work. I have no fun at all on these cruises. Now, looking forward to it. It's Port Canaveral cruise. It's always one of our good ones down in Florida. And then we have four more coming up this year. We'll do Baltimore in April.
That'll be nice for the Northerners.
Absolutely. And then a very interesting 13-night one-way cruise from Boston to Tampa.
Oh, that'll be fun. Now, that's an interesting one. I've never done a cruise quite like that. Lots of days at sea.
Yeah, we did a 13-night transatlantic last year. It was a blast. So we tried it again this year. So folks don't have to fly back from Europe. And once we get back to Tampa, we're going to immediately stay on the ship and go out for 5 more nights and then we'll move the passenger. So some of us, I know I will, hopefully some of our passengers, 18 full nights. That's a lot of poker at sea.
That sounds good to me.
Of course, folks can go to antiupcruises.com to get all the details on that.
2 or 3 weeks before
Yeah, it takes like 2 to 3 seconds.
I have been on one personally, so I can say how much fun it is.
This is really amazing.
And I could also say that Scott's not working.
I just give the impression that I'm not working.
The impression. You give a good impression.
Exactly. It's like giving the impression that I'm tight at the table when I'm not. 53 players is what we heard. Is that final? We still got time to get in. Good seats still available.
And definitely, I think that'll jack up with the rebuys. You cannot beat the rebuys here. Full stack, 500 plus 30. And especially because of the structure, that's a pretty amazing deal. Sure, you take a bad cooler, doesn't matter. You can jump back in at half price.
It was crazy.
Quick win for Mike there with suited big slick.
Got a bunch of blind chips.
So of course, guys, this is our first attempt at a live stream, and we're doing it a little bit more than you normally would see with multi cameras. And as you probably noticed, there've been a couple of switching issues with the webcams, which we're going to try to resolve at the next break. But the good news is we can still follow the action. We can still see the players, hear the players, and hear your wonderful commentary.
Make us look good.
Mostly wonderful.
Mostly wonderful.
I appreciate the confidence boost.
So these eight players at the table, we've got Joel Shaw from Guaranteed Rate. Joel is going to be one of the sponsors of the event. He's kind enough to come out and play. He canceled his Michigan trip this weekend to come out and play, so we're happy to have him.
Sunny Michigan.
As an Ohio State fan, I'm very glad that anybody canceled his Michigan trip.
Paul Fisher from Danley's Garage in seat number two. He's been a big supporter of both the charity events and the show and has done very well at our TV table and done very well lately in the tournament circuit. So he's been looking forward to this for a while.
I think he's been on every one of the Windy City Championship ones that I've called.
Not as many as Gary Carr, though, but almost every single one. Ron Majors, of course, from ABC 7 Chicago. Ron played at our 3K TV table last year and the year before. Had a good run of cards early, but poker just doesn't,
it's
fare
a
well sometimes. Yeah,
it's a marathon.
And next to Ron is one of his 2013 Sit and Go table mates, Mike Steinberg. Mike came here in 2013. He attended the World Poker Tour Boot Camp, then played in our 3K TV table. Of course, Jason Finn, the lovable host who used to work for Peanut Butter and Jelly Sandwiches, but now with two kids, yeah, he's got a paycheck coming. So we're happy to have him as well, and hopefully he stays around for a long time. Larry Lovable Loveliner, who didn't play a single hand in our May TV table, then chipped up and then got coolered. He is in seat number 6. And Larry came onto the set in 2010 to brag about knocking me out in the Heads Up event. My Pocket Kings versus Ace 10. Boom! All of a sudden, hey, he's got to brag to Scotty Clark and everybody.
Something that's worth bragging about.
I know, right? Somehow we got it on camera. I don't know how we did that. Next to him is Zach Elwood. Zach is an author and a poker tells expert. He came in from Oregon. And I guess it was like a 48-hour flight or something like that. But
but he's here, and he made it.
He's here.
Oregon's almost a whole different country.
And then David Wexler in seat number 8. Now, David is the owner of Little Guys Home Technology, another supporter of ours. Great guy, great poker player, and we're happy to have him as well. And
does he have any big guys working there?
No, just a bunch of little guys carrying big TVs. Speaking of poker, we just had a river card of a 10 of clubs. Joel with the Jack 10 catches up. He had 2 overs and a gut shot. Actually, no gut shot. 2 overs and just 2 overs. And a whole lot of heart.
That's all he needed was the 2 overs.
Yeah, he's got a lot of heart, too.
He's got a lot of heart.
He's got lots of hearts.
Of course, when you have pocket nines and you have a flop in a turn like that, you know the river is not going to help you.
It never will.
Joel continues to chip up here, looking really strong early on.
Very strong. But like I said before, it is a marathon.
75-150.
Absolutely.
No.
We got blinds posted and ready for another hand.
Working on two different things there, weren't we?
See, I want to play this just so I can put my cards in the RFID little spot there.
That's very cool. I've never actually played with the RFID.
500.
Raise to 500.
Now we're having fun. Queen 10. That used to be my favorite hand, going back to what you talked about. Again, no reason for it to be.
But it is.
Me too.
Me too.
Give me my cards back.
And then the more you play, the more you realize that Queen 10 is the worst favorite hand to have. Better off having 4-6.
We could have an interesting hand on this one here.
Check.
1,100.
1,100.
Everyone get a live card with Jason out here in front?
Lots of possibilities.
Larry takes the lead. Three of hearts, no help to anyone.
25.
Whoa! We got a runner.
What, we got 8 levels before the
week? Yeah. Oh, and wow, a call,
very
wow.
Good call from Joel. Not believing him.
Not at all.
Check.
Fortunately, that river was no help.
Check, check.
Unless he wants to go for it. Tough to call there if you're not going to go for it on the river.
Yeah. See, this game's a whole lot easier when you can see the cards.
I feel like that now.
Decent sized bet, he could have won there. But
I wish this is how it was all the time.
Exactly.
You get jumpy about those things.
So got Joel up ahead with Ron rounding out the top 8 here.
Even the short stack of 31,000. Plenty of play here.
It's really a great structure here at the Antiup Chicago Charity Classic. Structure is so important in tournaments. That's why I really think players really need to come out to events like this.
And it's funny how many of the recreational players don't pay attention to the structure.
That's
all they
true.
Care about is the number of chips they start with. And that actually has nothing to do with anything, right?
Not even a little bit. You start with 6 million chips, but if the big blind is 1 million, it's not incredibly helpful.
Exactly.
Now I'm nervous.
Joel playing a hand that I always like to play.
As you can see, Scott's range of hands here is interesting, to say the least.
You know what I like about the 9-5 suited, though, is if it hits, it hits.
No one thinks you have it.
Exactly. If it doesn't hit, it's easy to throw away.
Very true. Let's see if anyone's going to call Jason's raise here. Oh, I think Zach is going to call. Jason, not having incredible luck when he decides to raise. Zach will probably re-raise here.
I'm going to say it's definitely a re-raise coming here. So hard to do with a big blind, though, because that flop is so brutal, right?
It always is.
1600.
There's always one higher than your pocket pair.
Does make it 1600 to go.
Joel's out. Mike's out. What's Jason going to do here?
Poor Jason. There's two left feet this tournament, right?
And he calls. We're going to see a flop here.
Do you hate when you make those moves the wrong time? Every single time.
Right up the last 100.
Not dead, though. Lots of the good things could happen here for him.
Very true.
Heads up.
He's going to be an action killer, though.
Nope, but still an interesting flop. Yeah. You got backdoor flush draw, straight draw.
Enough here to keep Jason in, I think.
Actually, the same odds as when he started the hand.
Yep. Definitely a flop that Zach's going to like.
He has to think Jason has an ace here, I would think. So he has to know, depending on the card to come, where he's at. I think he'd probably make a strong raise here. Oh, no, same raise. Same raise as the re-raise on the flop.
A little smaller than I expected.
I think you got to stay if you're Jason here.
Zach is a tells expert, though, so maybe he's picking up something.
Oh.
What's up?
Seven of diamonds, no help to anyone.
Time for Zach to shut this down, I think.
Yeah, becoming another significant raise, I think, here. There's no flush scare card, so he could be getting tricky. Getting a little tricky. Wow. I like it.
I do like that, actually.
It's such an inducing type of check.
I'm not going to like it before ace comes, but...
This is true. At least he didn't get the backdoor flush draw on the turn.
He's going to let Jason make a mistake here. And now what do you do, though?
I think you got to wait a few seconds there to make that call.
If you're going to raise now, though.
That's a good point.
He's got to think he's best, right?
It's a very good point. You're not really inducing to try to go to the river.
He's going
to
call.
The call. This is interesting. I'll have to make sure I watch out for Zach there on the felt. Eight of hearts.
Such patience for Zach here.
And that's going to do it. Interesting play there on that hand, Scott.
Yeah, Jason just couldn't pull the trigger there in the end. I think he had an opening there with Zach slowing down the last two streets to
I think so.
Bluff his way into that pot. Probably wouldn't have worked, but
we'll never know.
153? 75, 150. You're close.
You just feel smarter when you can see all the cards. Yeah?
You always do. And the percentages, I feel like, are a lot easier than they usually are. I know everyone's percentages now.
Yeah, we were in a game last night, and everybody they ran it three times once. And talking about getting the calculators out to figure out the odds there.
Did you say something funny?
Yeah, you missed that too?
Yeah, I missed it.
No one's ever listening when I say something.
Unbelievable.
Nothing to write home about here until Zach wakes up with suited ace jack.
750. 750 now.
Oh, Ron, the big stack here. Is he going to want to come along for the ride?
Yeah. Call.
Sick.
David calls.
Jack Knight's another one of those hands that'll make him cry.
Smart of Ron to get out of that one.
Pretty good, actually. I'll tell you in a minute. Minute and a half.
Oh, look at this flop. Not that he needed any help, but
not that he needed it.
Well, Jack would have been better for him. He has no idea, though. So I like betting out here because no one thinks that you have it if you bet out here, right?
It's true. And it heads up hand, though, with David not have played that many hands. It's not a bad play.
Yeah.
That's good.
Zach will take it down.
I wouldn't mind it a little less. No kidding, really?
Good.
freestanding. I have two overs.
Both hands? You did not connect?
Big blind for one.
Okay.
Good one. Still looking for my first win. Let's do it. Let's do it. This is the hand I can
see. It's not on me. It's not on me. Let me fold for it.
Blind raise right here. Don't hold me there. Fine, I won't look. Don't hold me there. Look in the range,
calls.
Not incredible starting hands we've had so far.
And when we've had good ones, they've all been in the same hand.
Yep.
Which makes for great TV to watch. Makes for very difficult poker to play, though.
Check start.
Got some aces, some queens.
And our first seven deuce, and we've realized that this crowd is not a crowd that plays the seven deuce for fun.
Nope.
Check.
Ron still got the lead here. We're checking it around. Everyone's being nice. I hope everyone's this nice to me.
Check.
400.
There you go, Ron. Putting out a small bet there.
A little tiny bet just to see if you can win it. No one's got anything.
And that'll do it.
I had a four cut straight, but it didn't work.
Works in Yahtzee.
I think Jason Finn is bored. He wants to play Yahtzee.
He's going to give us a chance pretty soon here, I think, if he keeps playing the way he has been.
Definitely raising and getting caught against it there.
He's been stepping in every bear trap on the table so far today.
Speaking of Jellystone.
Yabba-dabba-doo. Do we have to pay royalty for that? No.
You said yabba boo boo.
Queen 10, that used to be my hand. Jason tightening up, not playing the suited 10-4.
It's a mistake in this play, I think. Obvious circuit.
Yeah, they only got about 15 minutes left in this level before they switch the tables out, so everyone's worried about looking silly. Paul doesn't even want to show his cards for some reason. Come on, Paul, put them on the RFID.
I like it. It's a little mystery.
And how far we've come from, you know, first, you know, no ability to see the cards to then the whole card cams. And now we don't even need the cams.
Providing feral cats in neighborhoods where they have rats. What they're doing is letting the feral cats live outside.
I think the mystery. I'm going to guess that Paul has a flush draw and two overs. Just hit one of them. 10-9 hearts.
And welcome to the Windy City mystery hand. Scott, what does Paul have on this hand?
I kind of like Kirk's analysis here. It could just be a big race, too.
If he leads out here, he hit the flush. Maybe. I don't know. I have no idea what I'm talking about, but I'm just going to guess. Paul, oh.
Just to be rogue, I'm going with 3-5s. Just kidding.
Oh, he had a paint card, which was no good. So he had nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Nothing.
And that's why I'm doing the production. We're trying to.
Joel is out in the lead. Still out in the lead.
So 28,000 units. Time to panic?
Not yet.
Yeah, players started with 40,000 chips. 400 big blinds to start.
Very nice.
You never know, though. It's still easy to spew away some chips sometimes. Big or little stack.
Raise to 300.
Again, they can rebuy for 500, correct?
Yeah, 500 plus 30 for a full stack. First eight levels.
And, of course, part of that rebuy benefits the Shady Oaks camp.
18.5% is the rake for the buy-in, so it's very fair compared to tournaments at casinos.
And it benefits a lot better than a casino.
Exactly. And we like to let the players know where the money goes, how much goes where, and, you know, when you're going to buy in for a buy-in like this, we're going to give you a good value. Get to play cards all day. Of course, one of the things a lot of people ask is, you know, it's a charity event. Do I win cash? What, you know, do I win prizes? What's the deal? Well, the Illinois Charitable Games Act only allows for $500 in cash above your original buy-in. So you could physically walk out with $500 in cash winnings, but the rest of it is a shopping spree. What do you want? Are you going to play the circuit event? Are you going to go out to Vegas? Are you going to fly? You got a cell phone bill. You know, basically anything that can award a gift card is what is allowable as a prize. So rather than forcing you to take a prize, the players get their option to pick and choose, And it's worked out very well the last couple of years.
Excellent.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of like Sail the Century. Remember that show?
Before my time.
Still in the Game Show Network.
Three players.
It stood the test of time. Not really.
Isn't the original Pyramid on the Game Show Network?
Yes, absolutely. You can tell I work from home.
Mostly Game Show. What do you mean work from home? Obviously. You're always on the road. You're in Italy. You're in the Bahamas.
When I'm not those places.
When you're not
at home on the couch watching.
So you didn't
old game
specify
shows.
That. Wow. You've got that DVR thing that jumps wherever you are. Sitting on the beach. You know what? I need to watch
an
a game show from 1970.
We have an all in here from Ron. Ron is he's in some serious trouble here.
Somebody has a lunch reservation.
Table for Ron.
Well, I think I might have to go get a rebuy ready for him. Because
it seems unlikely.
It would be a strange fold here. And I hope Joel gets out of the way of this one.
How much is it? 29,000.
And Joel is considering this call.
Wow. Lots of tears at this call
for
me.
Give away all my chips.
Ron just made a huge early biff.
Good luck, Ron.
Joel, make the same one.
I
think Joel is donating to charity on this one.
I just don't know how you can. I mean, he's got a gut shot.
All right.
We're almost as tired as that.
Thank you. It's good to know there's logic in the world.
I'm on the bigger girl.
Ouch. Ouch.
Not what you want to see there.
Got a mount here, though.
And you were there, weren't you? Straight. Nice hand.
Not going to do it.
That was not it.
And Ron is our first elimination here from the TV table.
Although he's not eliminated until he decides not to donate more to charity.
Good luck, guys.
At least that makes you feel better when you rebuy.
Yes, exactly. Oh, we see some handshaking going on here.
Jason looks antsy. He looks like he's ready to move away from this table.
So do we get other players?
I noticed not a lot of players wearing sunglasses except for
Larry.
That? Oh, that's yep. Larry there.
Yep.
Now the best poker sunglasses in the game is going to be Blue Shark Optics.
Never heard of this company. Tell me more about them.
Blue Shark Optics, greatest sunglasses in the poker world. You can get them right now at BlueSharkOptics.com. Use code INSTABSO, that's INSTABSO, for 10% off any order. You know Carrie. Carrie's a great guy.
Absolutely. Good friend. Yep.
You just had a major charity tournament with Carrie. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, Carrie's definitely got one of the biggest hearts in the poker industry. And came to me and wanted Andy up to help out with his online charity tournament. And kind of turned it on the head. Multi-venue charity.
Nationwide, I heard.
Actually, North America wide. We had properties in Canada joined as well too, and we thanks to the generosity of players and volunteers and poker venues all across, we raised enough food and cash for just shy of 45,000 meals.
45,000 meals. Now that shows some of the good that poker can do. I know sometimes it gets a bad rap
absolutely.
Out there in the public, but it has to really show the good it can do.
Definitely, definitely. And some of the venues just had a great time with it. Sent us a bunch of photos of all the stacks of cans. Venues threw in raffle prizes and gave folks extra chips for donating, so they made it a little bit easier for folks to do. And you're right, you know, poker, it's no matter what we do, it seems like it's still got this stigma attached to it, and we're fighting it. And I think the best way to fight it is to continue to do charity events like that and what we're watching right now.
Of course, of course.
Would you win the hand or no?
I would not have, sir. I was not going to win that hand after the river.
I guess I should have brought my Blue Shark Optics, but they don't really help you too much when you're not at the table here.
Now, actually, what I have found about Blue Shark Optics, which is actually interesting, is when I'm doing some different types of sporting, when I go mountain biking.
Oh, that's great.
The actual vision is so much better because you want to wear sunglasses, it's sunny and things like that. But if you're going down a trail or anything like that, you can see so much better than when you're wearing regular sunglasses. Even fishing too, I've noticed. Really, really interesting. You can see so much better what you're doing. Wearing those glasses because everything is bright still, but you have that protection from the sun.
Yep. It's very interesting in the places that you can use them.
Yeah, a lot of applications.
600.
It's got really anything here, so it's just a matter of who's going to bet.
Six.
Will the Patriots take it?
Raise the 1600.
Ooh, I like it. Joe didn't think he had anything there. He's feeling it's that Patriot to, pride. It's tough to raise into a small blind here, though, with this flop, right? I would think so. Not this he time. Knows his player, though. He does. Of course, he has chips to do that because he didn't donk him off on that ace-jack hand a couple hands ago. Very true, very true. I gotta think he was never seriously thinking about doing. Courtesy of that great hand, Dave is all the way up to just shy of 79,000 already.
I like
almost
the guy
double
that they with.
It's like the
that's a good. That's a good first hour. Double your stack in the first hour, especially in a tournament with a structure like this. A player like me, that's gold. Get off this TV thing and just sit for a while. I can come back in here. Did you see that hand I played, Scott? Didn't I play it well?
Yeah,
the good thing about spending your first hour here with me instead of playing while your chips get blinded off is you finished above Ron. And I've made zero mistakes up until this point. I can't wait to hear what you're going to say about me.
Okay, I'll do that. Just, I'll do that.
It'll be all nice things.
Oh,
well, that's nice.
That was me begging.
I'll be stretching the definition. I figured it had a broad definition.
Hey, listen, we're just friends here.
Hand with potential some trouble here.
I don't have any friends here.
It's a very angry table talk here between between Jason and Ron.
All of a sudden, you got new friends.
Or Jason and Mike.
A lot of connected cards going to see this flop. 965 all space.
Wow. We got a flop straight here. We got a flop bottom two pair.
So much for friends.
Flop top pair. Straight flush draw there with David.
Exactly.
Not only does he
and he's got
have
the only
straight.
Spade among the five people in this hand. Which
it's
is
a good
amazing,
spot to
right?
be in. You got to be afraid if a fourth spade hits the table.
Yeah.
All right. Depending which fourth spade it is, though. That's correct.
Just me?
Yep, heads up.
And me.
Mike trying to make a move here. Oh, coming back. Yeah, Mike's out of it.
Oh, Jason.
It's never the right time, is it?
Yeah.
It's hard to fault him for it, but yeah, he just keeps picking the wrong hand. I think with that many players in the hand, you have to be very careful about the types of raises you're going to make.
Exactly. I think this is one of those things where you just kind of try to get the showdown as cheaply as possible and hope it holds up, right?
Yep.
Or that you get a five or six here, which,
Nope.
I was the same boy.
Counter
for him.
Don't do it.
Okay.
You had
the queen.
My queen jack.
Yeah.
I'll consider your words.
I really am being a nice guy.
Chuck.
Jason considers the words.
And I'm putting him on a better queen or maybe a second.
We get a check, check.
That's good enough.
You only play straight.
Very nice, David, there on the river. I think he was like a tiny bit afraid of the paired board.
I put you on a better queen or maybe a set. I knew I was still on a draw.
And Jason is our short stack. He's just holding those chips, you get to see it. When you know when your stack gets so small, you can just hold it between two fingers. That's never fun.
That's when I usually ask people around me for change, right? Even if I don't need it.
Always, always.
Anything but a straight.
And I was still worried you had King Jack, which is why I didn't.
Still a little cold in the room, as you can see all the players are wearing jackets here. Not as cold as outside, though. What is it, like 25 degrees?
Never had
one. Yeah, pretty cold. You know, last night we left this game, and everybody ran outside that turned the car on to heat it up, except for the guy from Florida. Yeah, that's not something that we get.
Yeah.
Turn on the car to turn the AC on, maybe.
Sure. It's like a Pavlov experience there. Oh, I got to go warm my car up. Huh? What? Huh?
What do you mean warm it up? Doesn't it just start?
Three players.
Once again, a smattering of cruddy hands. I was just going to say, it'd be surprising to see an ace in this flop. And there
it
is.
How wrong I was. And not only that, but two pair hands.
It's a great position for Joel to be in here. I think there's a lot of money to be made in this pot, especially two of the largest chip stacks playing each other.
Yes.
I think this could be a good way to finish out our first hour of TV table. Mike may get this call. If we get a six on the turn, this is going to be a fantastic hand for the home audience. Because when you have these ace rag hands, that's the best thing right ever, to see that
it is
that
the best
rag on there. Because you can't think anybody else is playing a rag as well, too.
You hope Mike figures out his way out of this.
You have to say, don't worry, I got the straight.
This could be the biggest pot we see of the tournament so far.
15,500.
Make that decision easy.
Yeah. He's got a lot of chips.
Oh, another raise. No flush on the board. No straight. You got to want to string that one along a little.
It's going to be tough. Yeah, David's got to wonder. Oh, there's the eight. There's the six on the turn.
Wow.
Had there not been a raise this hand, we'd be really good. This is just too much for David to call here, I think.
No, you got to double up through Ron. You'll have plenty of chips left.
He's definitely considering it here.
You
just hope he can get away from it. It's a tough spot.
Very judicious with his chips in his first hour, so I can't imagine him.
No, no, there was that awful thing you did around.
It's a tough lane.
You know, you took the chump a while ago.
So now we're just trying to figure out, are you up against an ace-jack, ace-king, ace-queen, something like that? Or are you up against exactly what you're against, ace-eight?
I think you can even worry about a set in this hand, like pocket eights.
Very true.
So hopefully that maybe gives him a little more intuition there to get away from this one. It'll be a good fold by Joel.
Yeah, you can tell by how he picked up those cards. Oh! I thought...
He looked for sure like he was going to throw it away.
Definitely looked like a fold to me.
I believe that's called the pump fake. Yep.
I'm going to say he's going to go ahead and fold in. Anyhow, because you're going to go with your first...
That's what they say, but how many times have you gone against that?
Trying to decide if you could actually have a set of eights or not.
And he said just what I said. He could actually have a set of eights.
Oh, if that's what you're worried about, I'd call.
Joel is verbally trying to figure out where he's at right now, and he's not getting everything from David.
A set of eights would be tragic if he had it too. So
this might be worse.
And a call.
Oh,
there it is.
The call.
So close to folding, and there it is.
That's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt the morning, folks.
Wow.
Unless.
Cut out about 85%. 85% of. Or it increases by 85%.
And wow.
I figured that. Huge pot.
First hour here, two massive pots.
That was a fun way to end this first hour here.
Good reminder to not play these ace rag hands, right?
I'll remember that when I'm on the table. And while I'm a sponsored pro of Blue Shark Optics, I'm also a sponsored pro of Poker Life Gear at www.pokerlifegear.com. They make some of the most comfortable hoodies, shirts, hats, everything out there. It's kind of a new poker company. It's been around for about a year, but he makes some great stuff. So pokerlifegear.com, check it out.
Excellent.
And Scott, that's going to do it for me. This is Jason Solomon. I've had a great time, and I hope to not see you again, but there's always a possibility of that.
But here's the thing is I'm guaranteed to see you again because you're going to the TV table now, and I will be very very nice to hear from you.
Thanks a lot, Scott. Appreciate it.
You don't think I have twos. I don't think you have twos. We don't have twos.
I thought you had ace twos and you had ace. I thought he had a set of twos and you had ace eight.
Yeah. I'm already like
so I thought. You did have to be on the ace eight.
Yeah. Oh, the red one? Yeah.
No, it's you're
going to
actually scoot to your right so that you're actually
between,
like right here. You still have plenty of room. That way you're in frame.
Which one's three? This one, I would imagine.
Players, you're going to sit in seats 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So ignore 10 and 1.
So
player number
1 three,
is seat 2. Okay. Player number 2 three
is
seat
4.
Three.
So this one,
that's me.
Move over here.
Move over here.
This seat.
I believe so.
Right. There's eight chairs.
Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay,
this is the last jump.
I think this is.